Hi everyone, I'm Natalie from My Progression, and this is part two of our series on AI in the classroom. In part one, we explored some of the different ways AI could be used to enhance and speed up some of your teaching practices. If you haven't watched that video yet, please check it out using the link in the description below. In this video, we'll be exploring some of the do's and don'ts of AI in the classroom, looking at some hands-on examples, as well as looking at some of the things you must not do when using AI in education. For those of you not already using AI, think of it like having a genie in a lamp. As Arthur C. Clarke once said, any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. And that's how AI is being received. It can create and deliver on command like magic. I know we covered a bit of this in the previous video, but just to remind you that many generative AI tools like ChatGPT will take instructions in the form of a prompt. You write in your instructions and the AI will then work its magic. Don't like the result? You can then use the prompt to give it further instructions to improve on the original. As I said before, we're going to look at some do's and don'ts of using AI, starting with a do. Do use AI to automate all the boring things, repetitive tasks, or things that would take up your time. Maybe you just need a summary of a particular text. Maybe you've got a huge number of different model texts to create and very little time. Using AI to create model text is one of the most commonly used examples we've heard about in classrooms. We've even heard about schools suggesting teachers actively use ChatGPT for this. To write a prompt, think of the key ingredients you might need for that model text. Firstly, you'll need to say what type of text it's making. Is it a poem, a newspaper article, or a short story? If you're working on a particular topic or theme, you can incorporate that into your model text. You could write, write me a poem about children in a year six class time traveling to Roman Britain. Please use a sonnet form. You don't need the please, but I like to be polite when communicating with my software. And here, like magic, it appears. Maybe you want to do something a bit different, so you type, turn this into a limerick. And again, it appears in seconds. The results will vary. You may need to give it more information if you want it to include certain items or avoid certain themes. Now a don't. Don't use AI to do things you actively enjoy. If you want to be creative, be creative. Just because AI tools exist, it doesn't mean you have to use them. If you love writing poetry, then you should still write it. Another do. Do leverage AI to adapt your resources for a mixed ability class. You can use AI to have different versions of a model text to better suit the range of abilities in your class. Maybe you have an article that you've written yourself, but it doesn't feel appropriate for the whole class. So maybe you can modify the language to make it a more suitable example for children at different levels. Using AI for this can be an absolute lifesaver, allowing you to multiply your output. If you're finding this video helpful, please remember to like, subscribe, and click on the bell to keep hearing more from My Progression. Don't forget to check anything made by AI. It won't always get it right, and you'll find it's a starting point, but you will still need to change a given text manually to get it exactly as you need it. When using tools like ChatGPT, don't forget to tell it to correct language to UK English. By default, it'll be using American English, and more Zs will appear. That said, this is a useful way to spot anyone cheating on their homework. Do use AI to adjust the tone of your text. It's so much easier to write how we speak than to try to sound professional. With AI, you can type in your end of year reports in your own words, then ask ChatGPT to make the tone more formal. It will also help you use the right phrasing when providing the more challenging feedback. Don't feed personal data into apps. You could be breaking data protection regulations like GDPR by processing their information without their consent. Don't feed in personally identifiable data. For more on GDPR, see our video linked in the description below. Do use speech-to-text and text-to-speech features, as these are great for accessibility. If a dyslexic child has access to a laptop, then maybe they can read their work back to themselves using text-to-speak function to help them spot mistakes when hearing their words spoken out loud. From there, they can make their own corrections, and this is a strategy they can take into their working life. In fact, this is how Duncan, our camera op who has dyslexia, proofread this script. Speech to text is also really useful when you've got a lot of writing to do. Don't use AI to replace human interaction. For example, hiring decisions. A huge amount of communication is non-verbal, and this is something a computer will not be able to pick up on, as well as a real-life teacher. If you're a senior leader involved in such decisions, hiring other staff based on AI is not recommended, and nor should it be used to make other HR decisions. If you need support with recruitment, you'd be better off reaching out to an education recruitment agency like our recruitment partner, TeacherActive, to speed up your process. Do explore other types of AI. For those of you who may be a bit more tech savvy and already using ChatGPT, there are other tools out there that can massively improve your work if you're prepared to invest some time setting up flows that can help automate certain tasks. You may need to talk to your own IT department if you want to make use of these, and there are some associated costs. Have a look at TeachMate AI, designed by teachers for teachers. This site can help you generate slideshows, plan lessons and topics, and generate comprehension texts and questions. We've put a link in the description. Maybe you have some thoughts on the way you should use and shouldn't use AI in the classroom. If so, we would love to hear from you. Pop a comment in the section below. Now, don't forget, AI is created by humans. As a result, it is flawed and comes with some of the same prejudice and blind spots that the programmers may have. However, much of its knowledge can grow and fill with information over time. If you are using AI, make sure your texts are inclusive and look out for gender and racial bias. However much AI seems to be growing and working its way into every aspect of society, it is still just a tool. Every tool has its use, and it's up to you to decide when it's appropriate to use and how you want to use it. Always check your school policy or ask your line manager to check it's appropriate to use in your classroom. With these caveats understood, AI can be a game changer for teachers, allowing you to do far more in the little time you may have. Still not convinced? Give it a go. It's easier than you think. I've been Natalie from My Progression, and let's keep your career in motion.